I'm Lucky Flickerman, first ever host of the Hunger Games.
Enjoy the show.
5, 4,
enjoy the show.
3, 2,
enjoy the show. Enjoy the show.
What happens in there? Fueled with the terror of becoming prey. See how quickly we become predator? See how quickly civilization disappears?
There's a natural goodness built into us all. We can step across that line into evil, or not.
Welcome to another movie review. I am happy that you can join me today. If you are new to this channel, welcome. Click the subscribe button below for future notifications and updates. Click the like button and share this content with other movie fans. So, yesterday, Friday, November 17th, I went to see a 6 o'clock showing of the new Hunger Games prequel, okay? It is called The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes. So, it's considered to be a dystopian action film, and it stars Tom Blythe, Rachel Zegler, Peter Dinklage, and Viola Davis. It was directed by Francis Lawrence, and it is based on the book of the same name by Suzanne Collins. It was released in theaters yesterday, and the running time was 2 hours 37 minutes. The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes is a prequel to the Hunger Games franchise. Okay, so during the first 4 Hunger Games films, we follow Katniss Everdeen, and she participated in the 75th, I believe, annual Hunger Games. So, in this prequel, we are going backstage to the 10th Hunger Games. That's right, folks. This film takes place during the 10th Hunger Games, about 65 years prior to the events surrounding the first 4 films. And it follows the villain Coriolanus Snow when he was 19 years old. And it shows how he became the tyrannical leader of Panem. And when I first read the synopsis of this film, the question that I had was, why do we need a movie about the villain President Snow? That was my initial question. And so I went into this film trying to be as objective as I possibly could. And so here's what happened. And the movie is divided up into 3 chapters. So in a nutshell, Chapter 1 talks about the events leading up to the 10th Hunger Games. Chapter 2 talks about the actual Hunger Games. And Chapter 3 is what happens after the Hunger Games is over. So, during Chapter 1, Snow, played by Tom Blythe, is currently in a university, and he lives in the capital. And the movie starts off in a flashback where we see Snow, who was I think 10 or 12 years old, and you find out that he lost his father in the war. And then it moves forward to when he's 19, he's at the university, and you find out that his mother is also passed away, and she died at childbirth. And if she had lived, he would have had a sister. So he lost his sister in childbirth, he lost his mother, and he lost his father. So he lives with his grandmother and his cousin Tigress. So when he enters the university, he's kind of like the underdog, because his father was a big shot. However, his family lost their wealth. And so when he's assigned to be a mentor to one of the contestants of the 10th annual Hunger Games, he is in it to win because he needs the prize money. The head game maker of the games, Dr. Gall, played by Viola Davis, it's up to her to make the assignments. So she assigns him to the female contestant from the 12th district, Lucy Gray Beard, played by Rachel Zegler. In the end, I'm going to give this film 3 out of 5 stars. And what really bothers me, I mean, this goes back to, another review that I did a while back. I think it was for Priscilla. The ending can ruin a movie. And for me, with The Hunger Games, Act 3, the movie just went downhill during Act 3. I mean, it just did not work for me. What bothered me the most is, because Snow ends up becoming the dictator in Katniss Everdeen's world, and he's basically the villain, my hunch was correct. Do I need a movie about the origins of Snow? No, I don't. Was the origins of the Hunger Games interesting? Yes, it was, but I don't need a backstory about Snow. What I will say is, when after the movie was over, I read the synopsis of the film. I also read the plot synopsis of the book that this film is based on. And I must say that anybody who is a fan of this, of the Hunger Games books, they're going to be very satisfied with the film, because it sounds like the filmmakers stay true to the book. So for me personally, there were parts of Act 3 that I didn't quite understand. So that's why I needed to read the synopsis after it was over. And also, I wanted to see if some of the events in the movie was really from the book. And it happens that it is. So I think fans are going to be delighted that the filmmakers stay true to the book. But my issue is that since it's similar to the book, I guess this criticism is for the book and the film. In the first two acts, I felt some sense of hope. Especially when it came to Snow, because I think Snow was at an age where, you know, he was still empathetic, and he still had a heart, and he still cared, and he was emotionally invested in somebody other than himself. And then at the same time, you know, he has his flawed ways. And so he's at a crossroads in his life in which he's trying to determine, well, you know, should I give in to my evil desires or should I, you know, stay on the clear and cut path and try to be as good as I possibly can. And so in Act Three, you see the breakdown of his moral compass. Snow, because you know who he'll end up becoming, it's just kind of like, you know, do I care? Not anymore. And also, what happens to Lucy Gray in the end was also heartbreaking. And I kind of felt like a void was there, where you're just asking questions and you're just like, okay, like, what happened to her? So the film is an action film, but it turned into like this mystery in the end. What I will say is that technically speaking, it's a good film. The acting is strong. Lawrence did a pretty good job at directing. Some of the CGI was okay. Not bright and eye-popping, but it was okay. And, you know, some of the costumes I really liked. But in the end, it just has to do with the third act ruined the film for me. So let me know what you thought of the film. And feel free to comment in the comment box below. But that's all for today, my friends. And I will see you next time with another movie review. Take care and have fun at the movies.